I'm Mindi Messmer. This talk actually dovetails well off the previous speaker. I'm going to focus in on a community located in southern New Hampshire that has been the subject of a lot of attention, probably which they didn't really want to have focused on them. In early 2016, it was determined that two of the main municipal water supply wells in this town of Merrimack, New Hampshire, located in southern New Hampshire, had PFOA in excess of the EPA advisory limits at the time. And that started a whole investigation and a whole trying to get to the bottom of what the source of that PFOA was. And in 2002 or so, Saint Gobain Performance Plastics had come to the state of New Hampshire from Bennington, Vermont, where we now know there is widespread drinking water contamination with PFOA there as well. They left that behind and started up in Merrimack, New Hampshire. And they manufacture a bunch of products, mostly for the defense industry. They make these weatherproof radar antenna domes. They make food packaging material for the fast food industry. They make a lot of coated fabrics for the Department of Defense and for emergency response. And all of these have used or did use PFOA in the processing. So the state of New Hampshire back calculated what the historical emissions were from the plant, the PFOA historical emissions. So here's a graph showing you the state's estimation of what the PFOA emissions had been that had contaminated the drinking water in the area. And it happened through, you can see this conceptual diagram here, Saint Gobain's facilities in the middle here. The emissions go up into the air and then they're deposited and infiltrate into the ground surface and then down into the groundwater and into surface water bodies, as well as they leach out of sanitary landfills, which we heard a little bit about in our previous speaker's talk. And they ended up going into the groundwater and then polluting the water. About 40% of the water systems and the people in New Hampshire derive their drinking water from groundwater-based drinking water wells, and about 60% receive their water from municipal supplies. Here's a map showing the area in southern New Hampshire. Merrimack is just right smack in the middle, Saint Gobain, of this shaded area. And the shaded area indicates the area where Saint Gobain accepted responsibility for the drinking water pollution back in, I think it was 2018, through a consent decree with the state of New Hampshire. And these little dots show you the concentrations of PFOA in the private wells. The green dots indicate that the PFOA levels are below the state standards. The orange dots indicate that the PFOA levels are above the state standards. And then the PFOA concentrations that are shown by red dots indicate that the levels are above EPA's advisory. So you can see that there's quite a large area here. This is 65 square miles of southern New Hampshire about that's within this shaded area. But you can also see that the contaminated wells extend beyond this pink boundary. And that's actually the subject of a lot of concern, ongoing concern in the state of New Hampshire right now. In the past several years, about 964 private wells located within the pink shaded area from the previous slide have been provided bottled water because their PFOA concentrations exceed the state standards. We still have about 1,500 private wells within that shaded area where we don't know the concentration of PFOA, and that's something that's still unfolding. And there's about 1,100 wells located outside of that pink shaded area where concentrations are in excess of the PFOA concentrations are in excess of the state standard, but those people are not being provided bottled water or any remedy for the concentrations in their wells. So certainly an area of concern. This whole investigation is still unfolding. Like I said, it began in about 2016 and still trying to determine the extent of impacts related to the air emissions from Saint Gobain. I think probably previous speakers talked about this a little bit. We are starting to understand more about the health effects associated with PFAS exposure, in particular PFOA. Things like elevated cholesterol, thyroid disease, certain cancers, pregnancy-induced hypertension, ulcerative colitis, decreased fertility, some issues with efficacy of vaccines in children and those exposed to PFOA, and some other hormone disruptions and decreased birth weight in children. So a pretty long and growing list of health concerns. In 2015, 2016, actually 2016, 2017, the state of New Hampshire sampled a small portion of the Merrimack area residents, about 400 residents. Blood samples were collected for PFOA. There are about 26,000 residents in Merrimack, New Hampshire. And when you compare those concentrations of PFOA in the blood to the approximately appropriate national NHANES PFOA concentrations, you'll see that the people of Southern New Hampshire have about more than twice the US national level of PFOA in their blood during that same timeframe. So in 2018, the state of New Hampshire issued a report when they compared the rates of cancer in Merrimack to the rest of the state. They determined that the rates of cancer were not significantly higher than expected in the area. However, the people of the Merrimack area were not convinced that this actually answered their questions. They were concerned about various things, and they should have been, because it was comparing the rates of cancer to the rest of the state of New Hampshire. But they went out and they did their own community-led survey where they looked at a variety of outcomes, asked people door to door whether they hadn't experienced any of these things in their homes. And they found that elevated levels of autoimmune disease, kidney problems, cardiovascular disease, respiratory issues, and liver and reproductive disorders in the people of Merrimack. And their concerns were valid, I think, because the rest of the state of New Hampshire has pretty high cancer rates. New Hampshire has the highest pediatric cancer rate in the nation, as well as some of the other cancers, bladder cancer, esophageal cancer. And so their concerns about comparing the cancer rates to cancer rates in the rest of the state that were already high, was that really identifying the concerns that the, assessing the concerns that the community had? So we went about looking for some other towns that were demographically similar in New England and that didn't have any known documented PFOA in the drinking water supplies. We selected three towns in Maine, South Portland, Maine, Auburn, and Sanford, Maine, and then one town in Vermont, Colchester, Vermont, which didn't have PFOA in the drinking water supply. And it also had similar demographic characteristics to Merrimack, New Hampshire. We also included a town which we had at the beginning. I talked about how Bennington, New Hampshire had a documented PFOA widespread contamination of the drinking water supply. So we included that town, which was fairly demographically similar too, just to get an idea of what the cancer rates look like in Merrimack versus that town as well. And here's a slide that shows the results. Basically what we found was all-cause cancers in Merrimack when they were compared to the US national rates were not much different. But when you compared them to the pooled rates in the other demographically similar New England towns, they were elevated, along with prostate cancer, again, with the pooled and some of the towns, the demographically similar towns, direct comparison. Thyroid cancer, bladder cancer, and colon cancer were also elevated. But the thing about bladder cancer is that is naturally occurring, likely related to arsenic in the drinking water. So that's a regional effect. And you can see that most of the towns in New England have somewhat similar bladder cancer rates. And however, that bladder cancer rate in Merrimack exceeded the national rate. So it kind of tells you that there's something going on regionally. Then when we compared the cancer rates to Bennington, Vermont, which is the town in Vermont where there was widespread PFOA contamination, we found that the cancer rates were pretty similar. And they were also interestingly similar to Auburn, Maine, which was something we were kind of wondering about as we did this analysis. These cancer rates, by the way, are for 2005 to 2014. And that sort of made us wonder about that. Although there was no PFOA detected in the water system, right before we published our paper in Environmental Health Insights, the state of Maine identified 34 towns in the state of New Hampshire with high priority testing for PFAS due to historical sludge spreading activities that happened, and Auburn was on that list. So that kind of added a little bit of strength to our analysis, we thought. And then recently the state of New Hampshire issued another set of, another report on another set of data from 2009 to 2018, where they again compared the cancer rates to the rest of New Hampshire, and kidney cancer popped up as a statistically significantly higher rate of cancer in this community when compared to the rest of the state. But we were all we're still concerned about some of the other cancer rates that are borderline, as shown here. Colon cancer, esophageal cancer, bladder cancer gets close, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, and prostate cancer. Some of these, of you know, which we identified in our analysis, our ecological analysis, being high for this community when compared to demographically similar towns. So kidney cancer is still a concern, of course, when compared to the rest of the state. So we expect that some of these other cancers are actually higher when you compare, again, to these demographically similar towns in New England. So our findings basically are that PFOA serum levels for the small set of residents collected from that impacted area are more than twice the national average. And maybe when you compare one community cancer rate to the state average, where they're already above average rates, it might not tell the whole story. And the concerns of the citizens of that town were validated. For the 2005 to 2014 timeframe, we found that Merrimack residents experienced higher levels of mesothelioma, esophageal, bladder, and thyroid cancers when compared to national averages. For 2005 to 2014, they experienced higher rates of thyroid, prostate, colon, and bladder cancers when compared to similar towns in New England with no documented source of PFAS in the water systems. And then the relative risks were similar when compared to Auburn and Bennington, Vermont. Bennington, we said, has documented sources of PFAS contamination in the water supply. We suspect Auburn may also have a lot of private wells that may be impacted by the sludge spreading activities that happened in that community. And importantly, we think the cancer rates may be increasing in that community in Merrimack, New Hampshire, because the state's analysis for 2009 to 2018 concluded that there were higher rates of kidney cancer when compared to just the rest of the state. So we're concerned that that is a signal that cancer rates are still on the increase. Our results are reported in the paper. The study is the link to the reference. The citation is in below the findings. So we think that it's important to pay attention to the concerns of the community. We provided another way to look at addressing the health concerns expressed by the people in Merrimack. They're exposed to PFAS, in particular PFOA emissions historically, and felt that their concerns weren't being validated or heard. And so we suggest that this type of ecological analysis helps address some of those concerns and overcome the challenges that we face trying to assess public health concerns related to exposure. Just to give you an update, in the last few months, the state of New Hampshire required that Saint Gobain install emissions treatments on their stacks. And so that's ongoing right now. There are concerns around that, and it's a bumpy road, but hopefully that will go a long way to alleviating some of the exposure that community experiences. And just a last and final point I'd like to make is, this is an example of a community which is dealing with exposure from chemicals that are on the market, have widely been on the market since the late 1950s and 60s. In the last many years, EPA has really approved a lot of chemicals for use without a lot of knowledge about how the health may impact the citizens, the chemicals may impact the health of the citizens in those communities. And so I feel like we're constantly playing catch up in terms of evaluating the health outcomes associated with exposures after these chemicals are already on the market. This kind of shows how how many chemicals are approved, and then how many are evaluated for health issues, and then only 68 were regulated by EPA in the last 40 years or so, or 50 years. So we kind of feel like we're always playing catch up with the chemical industry. So be happy to answer any questions if anyone has any. Thanks for your attention.
There are a few questions.
Yeah, we probably have time for one.
Okay. In comparison of cancer incidence without adjusting for age or other known risk factors reasonable, this is comparable to comparing living incomes across decades without adjusting for inflation.
Yeah, that's a good comment. And that we had to go with what information was made available to us by the state and publicly issued documents. And that was one of our concerns. But you know, we did that kind of analysis the same way the state did. They did not analyze, they didn't, you know, do any of that type of analysis in their own analysis. So we had to kind of go on what was provided publicly to us. So that's how we did our analysis too.
Do we have time for more questions, Beth?
Yeah, maybe one more.
Okay. Since you did not use another New Hampshire community, how do you conclude that the Merrimack incident is unique to Merrimack and not simply reflective of New Hampshire, which you stated has higher rates in general as a state?
Yeah, unfortunately, the state does not make the data for other towns available. And that was actually, you know, the area that Merrimack is located in is a highly highly impacted area in southern New Hampshire. There's other sources of PFAS contamination widely in the water supplies of the seacoast of New Hampshire as well. And in addition, most of the density of the population is located in the southern portion of the state. So it's kind of compounding, you know, the issues with when you compare an elevated rate of cancer in a town versus, you know, with a lot of exposure, that's really what's driving the statewide rates. So that's why we searched for other towns that were similar in New England. And, you know, if you want to know that you have a somewhat clean comparator group, kind of like a drug trial where you look for, you know, you do a control group and then you do a placebo, you compare that to a placebo group. So that's kind of the approach we took.
Great, thank you.